Congratulations on the purchase of your new John Deere tractor. Your new tractor is equipped with a MiniPOD steering column control. Let's take a quick look at the operation of this MiniPOD. On the lower left side, you will find your turn signal lever. A simple push button horn switch is located on the end of this lever to activate the horn. This turn signal lever is equipped with a lane change feature. To indicate a right lane change, bump lever upward slightly to the first point of resistance and then release. The right turn indicator will automatically flash 3 times. Bump downward for a left lane change indicator. To indicate a right turn, push lever upward past the first resistance, then release lever. Right turn signal will flash until either the lever is bumped towards the left turn position or steering wheel is returned to straight ahead position. If road lights are on, pulling lever rearward will place lights in dim position. Moving forward will turn high beams on. When field lights are on, this lever will shuttle between your predetermined light settings 1 and 2. The optional left-hand reverser will have one of 3 different possible shift configurations based upon transmission options. These are 16-speed and E23 transmission, Auto Power IVT transmission without Command Pro, Auto Power IVT transmission with Command Pro. In our example, we are showing the left-hand reverser for an IVT transmission equipped with Command Pro joystick controls. To place into forward, simply pull towards you, then up to shift to the forward position. Lever will return to center position when released. To shuttle shift to reverse, lift and pull downward. Move lever upward again to shuttle shift back to forward. Wiper controls are located on the right-hand side of this MiniPOD. This control lever varies slightly depending on if it's equipped with a 2-wiper option, front and rear wipers, or 3-wiper option, front, right side, and rear. Front wiper is operated by turning the end of the lever. 4 speeds are available: low intermittent, high intermittent, low continuous, and high continuous. Front washer button is located on the end of this lever. Rear wiper has 2 speeds, intermittent and continuous. Rear washer is activated by depressing downward on switch. When equipped with optional right-hand side window wiper, an additional switch is located on this lever. To operate right side wiper, move the switch to select right window. This same switch previously used for the rear wiper now controls the right-hand wiper. Right-hand wiper has the same intermittent, continuous, and wash positions. If you wish to operate both right-hand and rear wipers together, place selector switch in the center position. Now wiper switch controls both front and side wipers together. The key switch operates a bit differently than that of previous tractors. It now has only 3 positions: off, run, and crank. This crank position also has a tip start feature. Placing the switch in the crank position signals the engine control module, or ECU. The ECU then activates the cranking motor to crank the engine. ECU will crank engine for approximately 60 seconds or until the engine starts, whichever occurs first. If engine does not start, you can cancel cranking by simply turning the key switch to the off position, or it will automatically stop cranking after 60 seconds. If engine does not start, ECU will prevent starter operation for a period of time, allowing for cranking motor to cool. Once sufficient time has elapsed, the ECU will once again allow cranking to resume.